Spicy.
Who else is she?
Yeah, boy.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We've got the first of two naming ceremonies going on today. And this one is a one that's very, very close to DRS's heart. Truly tremendous and magnificent story. And a fantastic outcome representing what is the best in British engineering. So I'd just like to introduce Mr. John Sharman, Chair of the Vulcan Society. Mr. Sharman.
Thank you very much, Chris. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is John Sharman, and I've had the great privilege of being the chairman of the Vulcan Society Trust, which some of you know about. And the first thing I want to do is express our heartfelt thanks to DRS for the opportunity, both of the occasion today, but also, as you'll see in a minute, of an ability which you never thought you would have to further expand how many people know about our aeroplane. Our aeroplane and this locomotive behind me have a number of things in common. The first one is the locomotive was born in the fire and brimstone of the Vulcan foundry, English Electric at Winslow. My aeroplane was designed to deliver fire and brimstone and confuse Her Majesty's enemies. There are a number of other similarities. Both my aeroplane and this locomotive have been rescued from what could be an inevitable future into a new, useful life. It took us slightly longer than this locomotive, but rescuing from an ignominious future icons of the excellence of British engineering. And in fact, they were both built very close to each other, one in Winslow and the other in Manchester, at the Avro factory. So to see another iconic piece of British engineering coming to the fore and being useful is fantastic. The other thing they share in common, as you can see if you look around you today, that this kind of engineering, this iconic engineering, inspires younger people to be standing right in front of them. And that's what we're going to do with our aeroplane. And you will be doing it every day by running up and down the track of the country with this locomotive, which is several years old now, but perfectly formed. So without much further ado, and again, thanks very much, I'd like to name this locomotive Avro Vulcan XA558.